Since Ghana hit oil and gas in commercial quantities a few years ago, the influx of big multinational companies in this sector has attracted greater investments and initiated business opportunities to prove Ghana as a new world investment destination. In this light, John Moore International has also placed itself in a good position. Not only as an indigenous company and the largest in West Africa, but as a number one projects logistics, transport and heavy lift supplier to attract the best partnerships, but also as one with the capacity to mobilize and deliver services equal to any in the world at very competitive prices. The FPSO, the largest infrastructure in the industry in Ghana, around which almost all the oil and gas drilling activities revolve, has come with many more infrastructural fabrications in line for completion. One of such activities is what John Moore International has been engaged for, to provide specialized services for its operation on the 10 block in partnership and collaboration with Group 5, MODEC and others.
John Moore International, appointed by MODEC Offshore Production Systems as the global freight forwarder, international project logistics, transport, heavy lifting, on-site management on the construction of 9 suction piles at the Sekendi Naval Base, which were carried out by MODEC. Fabrication was done by Group 5 and John Moore in charge of all the logistics on that project. Our scope of work included international freight forwarding, that is receiving materials globally and shipping it to the port of Tema and transporting it to the site. Other areas included trucking, transport, out-of-gauge cargo, craneage. All sizes of cranes were used on that project. 600-ton mobile cranes for the loadout, 400-ton cranes, crawler cranes were used for on-site fabrication, 120-ton mobile cranes, 100-ton cranes, 50-ton cranes. We had man lifts, we had telehandlers, we had low beds on site, and we did a general transport on-site logistics that was required, including all the heavy lift that was required for the project.
This is Sekendi Naval Base Tunnel Fabrication Yard. John Moore International provided the services, the logistical services, drainage, transport. Every single item here on site was freighted in by John Moore.
We were involved right from the beginning of the project. We brought in all the portable offices from Group 5, Takwa, to Sekendi Naval Base, and that helped us to establish the site.
All the chains, the bits and pieces, the welding machines and everything was transported in by the International.
We relied on our commercial department in Tema, because the bulk of the cargo came from Tema. And when the commercial department clears the goods, they hand it over to us to transport. The half shells were in the container, so its transportation was done by a normal flatbed. But then the can eyes were dimensional. Therefore, we had to use special load loaders to move them from Tema with escort to Sekendi site and hand it over to the fabricators to continue with the fabrication.
The shipments of the components of the suction piles came in 40-foot open-top containers. So these were shaped as can hulls. And once these arrived on site, they were joined together into half cans, which were then joined together to form the full completed suction pile. So 9 full cans were joined to form one completed suction pile. And all these were fitted with lifting trunnions and top pile jewelries to form a completed suction pile. Once the fabrication of the suction piles was completed, we had to bring in a self-propelled modular trailer, which helped in moving the semi-completed piles from where it was being fabricated, so that is the fabrication area, to the storage area. So when all of that was completed, we had to import a specialized equipment, which is a 600-ton crane with a super lift, to come and help with the top tail lift of the completed suction piles, and then the final loadout onto the batch.
This project was for the fabrication of 9 suction piles. They were 122 tons in weight, were 21 meters in length and they were 4.5 meters in diameter. The real heavy sections that were put together. And these suction piles, nine of them, were then loaded onto a barge by our heavy lift crane. The barge took this section piles offshore. They were going to be put in the seabed. These suction piles are going to be used for the production of oil. They'll be at the bottom of the seabed on the 10 field and connected to the new FPSO that is due to arrive in April 2016. Safety was of paramount interest because we had to ensure that this was going to be an incident-free operation. So we had to go through all the safety procedures, procedurals, the manuals. We had to do all our safety briefings. We had to make sure all our load charts were passed. And then every aspect of a lift or transport or men on site had to be clearly scrutinized and passed by the client. As an indigenous company, we are proud to have been associated with this project. We achieved our targets. It was an incident-free project. We completed ahead of schedule. And our team of, we had 98% of Ghanaian nationals who were part of this project. We came out incident-free and a big success story for us. And we look forward to being involved in other projects like this in the country in the near future.